There was a time when the only way to travel between Iowa and Illinois was by ferry across the Mississippi River or by crossing the government bridge between Rock Island, Illinois and Davenport, Iowa. The government bridge had been completed in 1886 and combined both a railroad and free highway swing span and was the first commission of a young engineer named Ralph Majewski. A Polish immigrant, Majewski went on to be considered America's greatest bridge builder, graduating from the School of Bridges and Roads at the top of his class in 1885, and ultimately opening his own design office in Chicago. The idea for what was to become the Iowa-Illinois Memorial Bridge began with William P. Bettendorf, an inventor, founder of the Bettendorf Company, and the city of Bettendorf. He dreamt of connecting his city to the city of Moline under the General Bridge Act of 1906. This act enabled private citizens to construct bridges as business ventures. His death in 1910 put bridge plans on hold, and the bridge remained an idea unfulfilled until May 26, 1928, with the passage of Public Law 533, enabling entrepreneurs that included William's younger brother Joseph W. Bettendorf and Moline Mayor Charles P. Skinner in a partnership to build a bridge connecting the two cities, turning the Tri-Cities into the Quad Cities. But there was still work to be done. The stock market crashed, and the newly formed Bridge Commission needed to convince the Iowa legislature to create a law that would allow the construction of the bridge. In addition, Moline had their own requests for street improvements before they would give their blessing to the bridge endeavor. After much legal maneuvering, construction began in earnest in June 1934 using 500 laborers employed through the National Reemployment Service at Davenport and Rock Island. The design for the bridge was completed by Majewski, Masters & Case, the same Ralph Majewski who had previously engineered the government bridge. It featured a 740-foot main span, a bridge length of 1,850 feet, and a total length of just over 5,500 feet. The suspension-designed bridge was open to traffic on November 18, 1935. And to pay back the $1.45 million cost, the bridge charged tolls. At that time, 15 cents per car and 5 cents per pedestrian walking. The bridge was originally dedicated to American World War I veterans of Illinois and Iowa, but that dedication has been expanded to include veterans from all wars. Shortly after World War II, it became apparent that the Memorial Bridge needed to expand to four lanes. As toll revenue increased, the monies needed to build were now available. However, both Bettendorf and Moline debated the construction of a second span, as it meant the demolition of dozens of historic buildings. After a two-year delay, construction began July 1, 1958. The second span was designed to be as close to the original as possible, though with a slightly larger road to accommodate the changes in vehicles in the ensuing years. At its dedication on January 20, 1960, the older span carried traffic north and the younger span south. Until the construction of the Centennial Bridge linking Rock Island, Illinois and Davenport, Iowa, the Memorial Bridge was the only uninterrupted crossing of the river in the Quad Cities area. However, by the mid-70s, the bridge was once again in need of an upgrade. Making the bridge part of the I-74 corridor, according to the Iowa-Illinois Corridor Study, would reduce traffic, create construction jobs, and boost economic growth. The renovation of the bridge was completed in 1975 and included the replacement of the railings, removal of the sidewalk and toll booth, and new elevated connection spans, earning the Memorial Bridge the nickname the I-74 Bridge. But as times, and more importantly, traffic have changed, the bridge became functionally obsolete. Once again, historic buildings would be demolished to make way for a new bridge, which would now be known as the I-74 Mississippi River Bridge. The design for the new structure marks the return of Majewski and Masters to familiar territory. According to Majewski and Masters, the new bridge will feature a new alignment to the east and will feature dual basket handle arch bridges with main channel spans of 800 feet. The bridges support 6 design lanes in each direction, including an outboard bicycle and pedestrian path. Preparation for the new bridge has already begun on both the Iowa and Illinois sides of the river. The total project, including the bridge, realignment of the highway, ramps, and other work between Avenue of the Cities in Moline and 53rd Street in Davenport, is expected to cost $1.2 billion. By the summer of 2017, construction on the bridge proper will begin in the Mississippi River, with workers building the framework for the new structure. Finally, as the work on the new bridge is completed and open to traffic, the Iowa-Illinois Memorial Bridge will be demolished sometime in 2021. And so these two states, joined not only by a river but by a bridge, continue to serve the Quad Cities and our nation.